Today we're going to look at the Fox box from Raytech. It's got a MOAT, Gary. We'll get to that. I've been fitting one today. It's just behind us here, and we're going to go through some of the points that I think were really key during that installation process. You've got one out on the table for me, and let me guess where you want to start.
Well, start in the MOAT.
Yeah. Your fingers are in there all day. Let's have a look then at your MOAT.
Yeah, so this is the MOAT, and it's full of ectoplasm, Gary.
Okay, for those Ghostbuster fans that are out there. Okay, yeah. And it's in both sides, I see. So there's two sides to this box.
Yeah, two sides. Obviously, one that you fix to the wall, and you can tell that by because it's got these external mountings, which means you don't mess with the IP integrity of the box itself.
Okay.
And the key thing is that, yeah, there's a lot of boxes out on the market that are suitable for use with resin, but you have to fill them up with resin yourself.
Yes.
Possibly when you finish the installation, this is pre-filled. And again, the gel stops the ingress of water. This forms the IP seal to all of the cable entries that are coming in.
Okay, so when you're talking about IP ratings, what's the IP rating, please, of the Fox?
So it's dual IP rated, so it's IP68, which is obviously the 6, fully sealed against any dust or other foreign bodies trying to get in there, and the 8 for water, so suitable for underwater. But it's also IP69, which is IP protected against hot jets of water.
Okay, really good. And give me an instance where we might be using this box. Obviously on the wall here, I've brought a conduit in and we'll talk about that, and an MYY cable. But there's some other instances that you think are really key.
Yeah, so lighting's great. Low voltage garden lighting, possibly a great where you have to bring lots of cables together and join them, but also things CCTV and some of the smart devices, because what you find a lot of, these are often supplied pre-cabled with some cables that may or may not be IP rated, but you might not want to disconnect them. So what the idea is, you lay them through the MOAT and into this open area in the middle where you can make your connections. And that remains clear of gel. So if you ever have to get back in there and make some alterations, you're not having to dig your way through. The gel is providing the IP rate.
And there's different ways of obviously moving in and through the actual seal, and it just depends on whether you're maybe bringing a conduit in or a cable. Let's start with the conduit. So I've got a footage here, Gordon, so let's have a look at this. So the conduit itself is just cut and just butted up to the section which will need to be split later on in order for the cables. This is the key bit though, isn't it, Gordon?
Yeah, top tip, put that lock ring on, and that's the thing about it. You don't need to add any additional glanding to the box as you would with a normal enclosure. You'd probably have to add a stuffing gland or a conduit adapter to it. These, you bring the conduit in and seal it with that lock ring that we saw there.
And it will accommodate 16, 20 and 32 mil conduit, depending on the adapter. Now at 20 mil, we didn't need an adapter. Do you want to get
the 20 mil's in. Out? So there's the one for the larger conduit, and then there's the one for the 16 mil conduit. You don't see 16 mil a lot in the UK.
Okay.
But then, bring that lock ring in.
And then we just put those up, and then we'll talk now about how we penetrate the MOAT when we're looking at conduit. Is that all right? Do that nice for me? Yeah. Okay, so let's have a look at that then. So when we bring a conduit in, the first piece of plastic there, we don't bring the conduit into the...
No, it stops at this first barrier, but you obviously have to bring the cables through. So you have to slit the barrier in the top and the bottom sections.
And how would you do that?
Just with our old friend, the knife.
Just bring the knife in, and then we just cut through those. So if this was a conduit, we make a slit for the cables.
Yeah, and you make another slit in the middle.
And is that just on the back plate?
No, it's both top and bottom.
So I would say that's a top tip, that you've got to make sure that you do it on both sides.
Have you seen you have to revisit that, Gary, when you're trying to put the top on?
It's a learning curve, I would suggest there. So, so with that then, the conduit stops before the sealing compound, the cables come through in order to get that one in. Then we looked at using MYY cable we really like on the channel, don't we, Gordon?
Yeah, so this product comes from Italy, where they use a lot of NYY, not so you don't see armoured cable so much in Europe, and we think this is a sort of underused cable in the UK market. And check out our video on NYY if you haven't seen it.
But now it's a round cable going in. There's a slightly different approach. Can you remember the diameters that we can accommodate in here?
Yes, so this will go all the way from 6 to 18 millimetre cables.
Again, depending on the adapter you use.
Exactly.
So. Okay, but again, slightly different approach now. So we want to offer this one in. So I've got this here, so we bring this one in. So what I did here, I've got to remember the bits again. Top tip, we want to say it again, make sure you put on the bits that you need before you make your final connections. There's an adapter for it. Again, it's got to be the correct way round. It's slightly chamfered. And then we've got this bit of kit. What's this called?
It's referred to as the spider in the instructions. Or black plastic bit with 8 legs. Actually, I didn't count up. It's got more than 8 legs. So,
So all of those have to go on first and the correct way round. Okay, and again, let's reiterate, that's a top tip, because the last thing you want to do is make all those connections and look down and you've missed one of them. You're obviously unconnecting anything. But this is where the moat comes into its own, Gordon. So we're going to make a split, so we can bring part of the cable into the actual gel itself. And then we make a second split in order that our conductors can lay in the section for terminating. And it's really important that we put the right amount of cable actually into what you call the moat. Do you want to show us that?
Yeah, so that the moat stops something, Gary. Actually, I would call capillary action.
Oh, right. Nice big word there. Can you explain a little bit more for me?
Well, a lot of people, and this is from incredibly painful experience in the past, that water can get into an enclosure actually through the middle of the cable.
So if, say, we had the five-way Fox box sealed up perfectly, the moisture could be coming in from the other end of the 40
seal
cable?
Well, if you look, just bring the camera in there, Gary, and see if I split those conductors open, you'll see here there's a nice little air gap down there.
Oh, right.
Yeah, so this could be, one end of the cable could be somewhere possibly unterminated or in a low IP area or somewhere where the seal has failed into our nice box here, but over time, as things heat up and cool down, water can actually be drawn through the cable.
Okay, so is that where the moat comes into its own?
So, if you, let's have a little closer look at that, at how that would work. So to stop that capillary action, we bring our outer sheath in to this level with this line here.
Okay, yep, so you've got to have that
press
into
it
there.
In, and then obviously the gel, once we bring the top half in, would seal around those cables and stop that capillary action from, down that.
So it wouldn't get past the waterproof gel? Oh, right, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, depending on whether you're putting a conduit in or a cable, so in this case, this MYY cable, it depends whether you're in the moat or not in the moat.
Yeah, conduit stays out of the moat, cable, you bring the sheath in and then split the conductors out. Obviously, with a conduit, it would, the singles would go through there anyway. You can also bring in a flexible conduit as well.
I'd like to think that maybe you'd be using a black one with a lovely black box here.
Not if you're a Newcastle United fan, Gary.
Okay.
But yeah, so that would fit in, there. And obviously the flexible cable, if you were bringing that in, you'd bring the outer sheath into the moat. If it was singles again, they just pass through.
But they do them in black, they also do them in grey. So maybe you'd be using white and grey together. I know you want your black and white. The covers themselves, again, from experience, you've got to be careful to put it on correctly. They're in the instructions. It's a firm press at the top and then in each corner. It's not so clear on here. So obviously I've laid my cables within the enclosure. I've made all my appropriate slits, and now it's a case of just firmly pushing the lid on, and obviously these two sections then seal to give you the IP rating. Wind in my nuts in order to make sure the connections, but there's some other nuts I've got to wind in as well, Gordon.
Yeah, so we've got the five-way version here, so we've just blanked off the, remaining two unused ways with the lock nuts that come with that, but yeah, you can get a three-way version.
And you can also get a two-way version, can't you? Because we've used it here. Just remind me which one of the Flintstones this is down here.
Yes, we've got Fred.
We've got Fred.
Which I think we'll probably need to look at in another video, because that's, again, a sort of smaller version of this that stops that capillary action.
A slightly smaller version, yes, it is. But for what I used it for, to make that connection from an MYY cable to the actual light itself, I thought that was a great way of making that final connection.
Yeah, and very the size down here. Yeah, sometimes you end up, some installations I've seen now, you end up with a bigger junction box than the light fitting.
Okay. As always, we're interested in the boxes you're using in outdoor installations. Are you currently using either the Fred or the Fox box in order to make your connections? Where would you use them in electrical installations? We always want those comments. Please leave them below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.